students, we are talking about science, right? In that, we will be talking about chemistry. So over here, as you already know that there are formation of ions. But ions are charged, right? So there is positive charge as well as negative charge. So if there is presence of different charges, opposite charges, then what they will do? They will actually combine together and will form ionic compound. So in this particular module, we will see how to write the formula of ionic compound. Now, let us see how to derive the particular formula for ionic compounds. Okay, so over here, as you know that in periodic table, there are many groups which are present. And if I'm talking about any group, it will acquire a particular charge. So if I'm talking about first group, it will acquire plus one charge. If I'm talking about second group, it will acquire plus two charge. If I'm talking about the 13th group, it will acquire the plus three charge. Then if I'm talking about say 15th group, it will easily acquire minus three charge. If I'm talking about 16th group, it will acquire minus two charge, and 17th group will acquire minus one charge. So over here, we will be only seeing the particular elements which are commonly seen. Okay, other elements also form the charged particle, but it is rare. So we are not talking about that particular thing right now. Okay, now if I'm having a particular example, say magnesium nitride, how to write the particular formula for it? So Mg, as you can see that it is a member of group 2, that means it will have plus 2 charge. And the other one is nitride. Nitride means it is another way of saying nitrogen. Nitrogen, when acquire negative charge, instead of nitrogen we call it as nitride. Okay, so nitrogen is having 3 minus charge because it belongs to group 15, correct? Now if I'm talking about writing the particular formula for magnesium nitride, remember that I have to balance their charges. So let us say that I'm having 1 Mg2+ and 1 N3-. What is the charge? Positive charge is plus 2 and negative charge is minus 3. Now let us add one more ion to each of it. So then what will happen? If I add one more Mg2+, then the total positive charge will be plus 4. And if I add one more nitride, then N3-. So total charge will be minus 6. Now let us add one more Mg2+ to the cation. Then 3 Mg2+ means plus 6 charge. And over here, for 2 nitride, there will be minus 6 charge. Right, so over here what I am doing, I am keep on adding the particular ions till the charges are balanced. Now how many magnesium ion am I having? 3. How many nitrogen ion am I having? I am having 2. So what should be the formula? It is Mg3N2. Is there any other method by which I can do it? Yes, so if I write Mg2+ and N3-, then the easiest method is write the charge of nitrogen 2 Mg and write the charge of Mg 2 nitrogen. Then what will be the answer? It will be again Mg3N2. So this is the trick by which you can do it. Okay, but over here this is the method of deriving it and this is the short trick. Okay, to make your concept stronger and stay ahead in your learning journey, join me and other subject matter experts on Tutorito app. For daily free concept classes, download the app right now.